Hello, I'm Ken Mollet, president and owner of Webinar Success. In this recording, I'm going to help you consider points of view when preparing and promoting a web seminar. To create a successful webinar, you must consider two different perspectives. One is your company's goals. What are you trying to accomplish with your web event? The other is your audience's motivation. Why are they interested in attending? You obviously need to start with your goals in mind. There has to be a good reason for you to invest the time and effort involved in creating a webcast. Think very carefully about specific desired results that you want to see. Webinars are often ineffective because the creators do not have a clear target outcome established. We often see unclear goals in educational webinars. For instance, if your stated objective is to educate customers about your new release, you haven't thought things through far enough yet. Educating your customers is not a goal. It's a means to achieving some other desired outcome. Why do you want to educate them about the new release? Some possibilities might include: you want your customers to upgrade to the latest release to ease the burden of supporting past versions. Or you need to retain customers by making them aware of a technical superiority over your competitors. You might want to improve more widespread adoption and use of your product in your client companies by demonstrating practical applications and making your customers more enthusiastic about your product. The way you approach the content and tone of the webinar will change dramatically based on which of these goals you're using the training to achieve. Marketing webinars often suffer from unclear goals as well. It is not enough to say that your purpose is to generate leads. Get specific about what effect your broadcast should have on your audience. Again, here are just a few of the many possibilities you might consider. Do you want your audience to place an online order at the end of the event? Or do you want your audience to accept a post-event sales call to move them down a longer sales path? Perhaps you want your audience to read and download more detailed information from your website. As you can see from just these two examples of educational and lead generation webinars, the same type of event can have a variety of underlying motives. It's difficult to be effective at achieving your goals until you're clear on exactly what you want to accomplish. When you can clearly and unambiguously state your goals for an event, you should write them down and make sure that everyone involved in the event has them as a clear focus. They will affect the content you create, the marketing and promotion you use to publicize the event, the presentation style that your speaker uses, and the way that follow-up is to be handled. They also give you the only practical way to measure and evaluate the effectiveness of your event. Unfortunately, having your goals clearly defined is only half the battle. You now need to switch gears and start to think like your potential audience members. What motivates them? What interests them? Why should they care about your content? Let's play with this concept of competing points of view by using one of our previous example scenarios. We'll go back to the idea that you are a software manufacturer with a new product release. You decide to give a webinar telling people about the features in your latest version. You have your own goals, which focus on promoting customer adoption of the new release. You might start by thinking about the event title. A simple descriptive working title could be New Features in Release 4. Certainly accurate, but not very helpful for you or your audience. If you wanted to help clarify your purpose, you could change your title to Promoting Customer Adoption of Release 4. This would be useful for guiding your event's promotion team and the people building slides in a script, but not something you'd want to show your audience. The external view of the event must frame the content in terms of a benefit that outweighs the effort and time your viewers will have to spend. What are some of the things that offer perceived value to your viewers? If you're trying to reach developers, you might appeal to their frustrations with workload and deadlines, perhaps using Release 4 to improve development speed. If you're targeting managers and purchasing decision makers, you might address their concerns about costs and reliability. For instance, improving your bottom line with Release 4. The value to your audience should be made explicit at every step of the process, from event titles to invitations, event information pages, promotional activities, and presentation content. Force yourself to think in sentence phrases that begin with direct promises to your audience. You should be able to categorize your information in terms such as you will achieve, you will benefit, you will learn how, or you will improve. While you don't have to write those phrases out verbatim, your materials should work to convey the sense of value so that your audience does not have to make the conceptual link between a piece of information you present and the way that they can benefit from it. The two points of view come together in the content of your presentation. Your goals for what you want to achieve with the webinar dictate what pieces of information you will include. Your understanding of audience motivation and interests will change the way in which that information is presented and framed. By designing your web events to accomplish specific business objectives and meet your audience's expectations, you increase the value from both points of view. You can measure effectiveness of your webinars against a clearly defined set of goals, and you can attract and retain more viewers by offering them a compelling reason to attend and to follow through after the event. Webinar Success offers consulting and assistance with all aspects of web seminar production. I invite you to visit our website or email us for more information.